Israel has been accused of unlawfully dropping white phosphorus over residential buildings in Lebanon. A report by Human Rights Watch says Israel's forces deployed the substance in at least 17 towns since October last year.
There's a lot of pressure building on the Lebanese-Israeli border, and it's escalated massively over the past few days. This latest round of Hezbollah attacks is clearly testing tempers, with both sides now threatening all-out war. The Israeli War Cabinet's emergency meeting was quickly followed by the Israeli leader visiting troops and emergency workers in the north. "We are ready to strike," he seemed to be suggesting.
"Whoever thinks that he will hurt us and we will sit idly by is making a big mistake. We are prepared for a very strong action in the north."
The Israelis have been hitting further inside Lebanon. If we look again, the pictures are hazy but appear to show white phosphorus being used. The claims come on top of an investigation by Human Rights Watch, which details widespread use of white phosphorus by the Israeli military in Lebanon. The human rights group focused on the months immediately after October the 7th, when these areas were full of residents. The use of white phosphorus to drive out people, burn land, or fired indiscriminately in populated areas is outlawed under international law.
This documentation, I think, should raise the alarms with states that are providing weapons or arms with Israel, because there is a real risk that such arms are going to be used in violation or may be used in violation of international law, whether it's in Gaza but also in Lebanon.
Our own investigations in Lebanon found evidence of widespread burning of land, although we cannot confirm by whom. When we contacted the IDF, they vehemently denied using white phosphorus illegally. But they said they do possess smokescreen shells that include white phosphorus that are legal under international law. These shells are used by the IDF for creating smokescreens, they said, and not for targeting or causing fires, and are not defined under law as incendiary weapons. But tens of thousands have been forced out of their homes on both sides of the border, 100,000 in Lebanon alone, according to the foreign ministry, causing a displacement crisis. Many of them are farmers, like this man, who told us of the scorched earth policy they believe is being used against them.
"When the phosphorus is fired, it drops something like powder. It sprays something yellow and has a bad smell. All our land in the south is affected by it. In the beginning of the war, they dropped a lot of phosphorus."
The many Lebanese residents we've been talking to over several months appear to back up the investigation by Human Rights Watch. We found residents who don't want to be identified in Kefir Kella, who showed us pictures from an attack the night before we arrived. It looks very much like white phosphorus being fired from Israel.
"They're trying to suffocate us, start fires and burn all our land. Why do they want to hit us? Why do they want to hit a civilian area? Are they allowed to hit a civilian area?"
But the Israeli military insists it's hitting Hezbollah targets from where the Hamas ally is launching attacks against Israel. The villagers we spoke to say these attacks are unpredictable. The fires are difficult to extinguish and they've suffered breathing difficulties. They're one of the few families still in the area, nervous about speaking because of possible Israeli retribution, but also worried about incurring Hezbollah wrath by talking to foreign media. The area was clearly still very active whilst we were there. And now the Arab media is awash with reports of diplomatic warnings from several Western envoys about an imminent Israeli attack on Lebanon. "Prepare for war," one is thought to have told the Lebanese. The escalation over the past few days has only fueled those worries of all-out war between the two neighbors. Alex Crawford, Sky News.